Thank you for buying this GMC double bevel slide miter saw. Use the carry handle to carefully lift the saw from the carton and place it on a level work surface. First, check over all the components visually. Remove the cable tie and check the lead. If you find any signs of damage, put all the items back in the box and return the product to your retailer. Slot the clamp support bracket into one of the fence holes on either side of the blade and secure by tightening the clamp assembly lock. Slide the dust bag onto the dust extraction port. To attach the side bars, first loosen the bar locking screws with the hex key provided. Insert the side support bars into the location holes on either side of the table, then tighten the locking screws to secure into position. We recommend that you secure your miter saw to a workbench using the holes on each corner. To release the saw arm, push down, release the knob, then hold the operating handle and slowly raise the saw arm. Put on all the safety equipment needed to use this tool. Now plug the miter saw into the mains. Press the red eye laser switch to turn it on. Loosen the clamp and slide the workpiece along the bed until your pencil line is aligned with the laser. Tighten the clamping arm to secure the workpiece into position. When cutting narrow pieces of material, you will not need to use the sliding mechanism. For larger pieces, loosen the slide locking screw and grip the handle. Keeping both hands well clear of the blade, squeeze the on-off switch to activate the saw. Slowly lower the blade into the material and cut through to its bottom edge. Then slide the saw blade along the laser line to cut through the entire width of the material. Release the on-off switch and allow the blade to come to a complete stop before lifting. Whenever you make any adjustments, disconnect the miter saw from the power supply. To adjust for a miter cut, loosen the miter table locking screw and rotate the miter table to the required angle. Retighten the locking screw to secure the table in position. To adjust for a bevel cut, loosen the bevel locking handle and move the saw arm to the required angle. Retighten the locking handle to secure the saw arm at the correct angle. For a compound miter cut, adjust both miter table and bevel to the required angles. To alter the cutting depth, slide the trench stop to the left and rotate the trench depth adjustment screw to set the depth required. Lock the setting with the trenching depth lock nut. After cutting, disconnect the miter saw from the power supply. Remove the dust bag and empty the contents into the trash. Use a dry brush to clean the vents and clear the base of excess dust. Ensure the miter saw is not connected to a power supply. Check that the slide locking screw is fastened. Remove the screws to release the guard retraction arm and the rotating blade guard. You can now remove the blade bolt cover. Pull the rotating blade guard down, then swing it up over the upper fixed guard. Depress the spindle lock button and use a hex key to loosen and remove the blade bolt. Be aware that the thread is left-handed, so rotate the bolt clockwise to loosen. Mount the new blade on the shaft, making sure that the rotational arrows printed on the blade are pointing in the same direction as the arrow on the fixed guard. Secure the blade in position with the blade bolt and replace the guard. Check the miter saw is not connected to the power supply. Push the saw arm down and lock into the transport position. Loosen the miter lock, rotate the table and lock it at the 0 degrees position. Loosen the bevel lock and set the saw arm at 0 degrees bevel so that the blade is at 90 degrees to the table. You can use a set square to check the alignment. Turn the blade by hand to check the alignment throughout its rotation. If the blade angles away from the set square, then use a suitable wrench to loosen the lock nut securing the bevel adjustment screw. Also loosen the bevel lock. Use a hex key to loosen the blade bolt and adjust the alignment. Retighten when the alignment is true. If you need to realign the zero indicator at the front, loosen these two screws to adjust the pointer as needed, then retighten. Check the miter saw is not connected to the power supply and set the saw arm in the transport position. Loosen the miter lock and set the table at 0 degrees. Using the hex key, loosen the retaining screw and remove the top section of the right-hand side fence. Loosen the 4 screws securing the fence to the base. Adjust the fence so that it is square with the blade. You can use a set square to check the alignment. Then, retighten the screws to secure the fence in position. If needed, adjust the position of the pointer of the miter scale using a crosshead screwdriver. Lower the blade arm, and then engage the release knob to lock the blade in position. Use the transportation handle to carry the miter saw.